Trouble started in Punjab. Where were you?
I was first in Lahore and then I came to Jalandhar. It started, you see, in month of June, May, June itself. Many instances started taking place in May. But June, it started in a big way. After 15th of August, the situation was quite different. Then it was a massacre. Not only the incidents which had taken place, humanity was being butchered in both sides. And men, you see, I have seen at that time, even the congressmen who were supposed to be secular, except some exceptions were there, they got involved into the riots, killing the people, innocent people. Secularism was knocked at its base, and only we communists were remained in both sides to defend the minorities. And we also were singled, and one of our very leading personalities in Amritsar was killed while defending the minorities. This was the situation at that time.
You were from West Punjab, your family?
No, I'm from East Punjab, but I was staying in Lahore, Lahore being the headquarters of our party. I used to stay in the headquarters, which was in 114 McLeod Road. There, I remember the telephone number, which was 2946, because I was working there. And I had to see, but once Nehru had agreed to the total migration, then you cannot imagine the scenes one could not see. I was moving around at that time in Jalandhar district, defending the minorities everywhere at the risk of my life. And my wife and my sister, they, from all my village, the Muslims who were numbered 200, were brought to our house, and they were protected for 1 month, and I safely sent them to, got settled in Lalpur district, safely sent them there.
Which was your village?
My village is Bundala district, Jalandhar. It is near Noor Mahal.
Who was doing the attacking at this stage in Jalandhar district? Who
were attacking? You see, people were mad. I tell you, there are few organized groups working. Behind them was Maharaja Patiala too, and Akali Party, and the congressmen also. But people in general were looting. They got involved in looting. And there are few groups organized with weapons and trained. And they were involved in killing of the innocent people. This side, and same thing was happening that side. And when Nehru agreed to total migration of population, it was a horrible thing, you see, when the people came to know they have leave their homes and herds. It was a very difficult job. And on the way, when they are moving with the bullock carts and everything, belongings, and they were even massacred on both sides. And trains, you could not see the trains. People used to get the people from trains. They had become completely inhuman. In fact, I had a quarrel with the late foreign prime minister. There was a national integration meeting here. And he said to me, "Do you mean to say the minorities don't indulge in violence, only it's the majority which attacks? What happened in Punjab?" I told him, "Murarji bhai, you were in Gujarat at that time. I was in the thick of the battle. I saw even the congressmen when scratched were found to be the communists. They had given up secularism. They had given up ideology which Nehru has imbibed. They had imbibed from Nehru. That was the position at that time."
Can you give me, for the benefit of my listeners who will not really understand what happened, can you give me some idea of what you saw? What particularly shocked you about that moment?
Shocked, most shocking instance was nobody was considered a human being. You do not even treat the cattle the way you were treating the humans. If someone belonged to the minority, here the Muslims, they mercilessly were being killed and nobody to defend them. There are few where our party was strong. They were coming forward to defend them, and it's only those villages where we had a strength, they were protected. But we also could not keep them this side. They had to leave. And if you see, even when they were moving together to go to Pakistan, even at that time, you would see that wherever the people used to come and attack them, kill the innocent children, women, no discrimination. One cannot imagine when one reminds of that thing, you see. It is shocking event. Both sides. The same thing was happening to that side. I tell you, One Abdul Ghani Dhar was an important Congress leader from Ludhiana. It is difficult to protect him there in Ludhiana. So I took him to the Chief Minister at that time, which was Dr. Gopichand Bhargava. I said, you provide protection to him, do something for him, he has given the whole life for the Congress party. Do you know what reply, shocking reply I got from him? Have you seen that downside, how the people are being butchered? I had to abuse him at that time. I was working with him in the Congress for long. I had to abuse him. This is what you are sitting here. This is Gandhi's message, which you are supposed to be a Gandhiite. Like that. That was the situation. Dr. Saifuddin Kichlu, who was the hero of Jallianwala Bagh, who was a very respected congressman in the state, has been the president of the state Congress and a prominent national leader. His life he could not protect in Amritsar. He was taken to Delhi, and Nehru protected him here. Delhi provided protection to him. This was a situation terrible.
Did you yourself see people being killed?
I was defending them. I was roaming from village to village. I was going around organizing the people and choosing them. And that is why many could be saved and safely where we were strong, had some base. There the people could be protected strongly. You cannot imagine that scene. One reminds even now and see what had happened to the humanity.
Women in particular suffered in Punjab.
Women, children, nobody discriminated against. You see, the question was, many people, some people had that ideology of killing, finishing the minorities on both sides. Same was happening that side also, Pakistan side also. But some were for looting. And for the purpose of looting, they were indulging on these activities.
Are there any particular things that you saw or heard about that stick in your mind?
Sticking in my mind is usually the rainfall. There was a rain. They were moving in batches of 100, 50, 200 batches. And even then they were attacked. There is one stream in between Jalandhar and Phagwada. One stream goes, a rivulet is there. On that bank, people came and attacked, and I was helpless. Before my eyes, they were butchered there. And the train coming from there, if somebody had come, they safely is all right. I have seen the trains from that side, how they were being killed that side. And the train also, you see the bodies, dead bodies of children, women and men.
How were people killed? Were people stabbed or shot?
Shot, killed with swords, guns, every weapon was used. It was a horrible scene.
What made people mad? You use the word mad. What made them so mad?
Criminal frenzy was around to that extent. Criminal frenzy was around. That is why we are against criminalism. You see, criminal frenzy was around to that extent. I tell you, we started. Earlier, Punjab was very safe. Muslim League could not have roots in Punjab. Because here there was a Unionist party which was dominating. Though they represented the feudal interests and they were loyalists, at the same time they were not criminal. And this side, Chhoturam's influence was there. He was represented the landlord interest, but at the same time he was not criminal. In Haryana side, this side. And in the western side, it was a Unionist party, Sir Sikandar Rehat, Khizr Rehat. These fellows were there. But they never allowed the League to penetrate into Punjab. It was only when we had agreed to partition. From 1946 onwards, League began penetrating there. Before that, no League was there. It was the Unionist Party there. When they began penetrating, then the Akalis also began taking with different dreams. Rajas had the dreams. If this thing happened, we'll carve their own six state. We'll be able to carve that. All sort of ambitions came up. And that forced them, enabled them to train people, to drive away people. All these things were happening. This is what has happened at that time.
You're a Punjabi. You came to prominence as a peasant leader.
Yes.
Within the CPI.
Yes.
Yet what happened in 47 is a great blot on the reputation of the people and the peasantry of Punjab.
No, it was a horrible, I tell you, that is what, now also when you see the political scene in Punjab, its root lies there. It is that massacre, that you see the attack against the humanity, which has poisoned the minds of the people at that time. It is that which is coming in the way, the communalism which is showing there, coming to the head there, and the democratic traditions. Punjab has very rich traditions because they have sacrificed big. Nobody can compare with Punjab in sacrificing as the people of Punjab, because there, not one, innumerable persons had sacrificed. Ghadar Party, Jallianwala Bagh, Bhagat Singh, Shaheed Bhagat Singh, all so many martyrs they have produced. Even the Akali Party have served the peasantry in the struggle for independence. The same Punjab, when this thing happened, after that poisonous atmosphere prevailed. They disrupted the unity with the forged by the Punjabi people in the struggle for freedom. That happened, and all ambitions of the landed interest of the feudal princes had their own ambitions. After that, we will be able to carve perhaps our own states and all that. All sorts of things came.
And now Muslims make up just 1% of the population of Punjab.
That is only, you see, because in one state, that also would not happen there. In one state, that Mareer Kotla prince, he came to understanding with Maharaja of Patiala. And he came to understand, you don't disturb me, I will not do anything, whatever you do outside, killing and others, I will not intervene in the affair. That understanding helped. I don't know what was the reason behind that and all this thing. Understanding between Patiala and Mareer Kotla, that we are your servants from the beginning, we are helping the Sikhs and all this thing. That understanding, but that state was protected. Otherwise, nowhere. There's some isolated thing. Now people are there, some people, some 200, 300, some cities are there. But at that time, nobody had remained. Only some isolated people were there, old people who were left over. They were there at that time.
I've spoken to Daniel Latifi, who was ordered by the CPI to join the Punjabi Muslim League and helped draft their election manifesto. Do you think that the CPI made a mistake in encouraging the Muslim League in the mid-40s?
Naturally, at that time, it was a big mistake, and we have stated not only that, sporting the slogan of Pakistan, it was a big mistake on the part of the CPI, thinking, you see, following that independent struggle. They did not rely on the people at that time. They thought that the British will come in the way of independent struggle if this is agreed upon. The two-nation theory, which was promoted by Rajagopalacharya, it was swallowed to an extent by the CPI also at that time, but was discarded by that time. But those who had went to the League, and many communists had joined the League, those who went to the League, it was very difficult at that time to give up that position. This very, no, he is, Daniel is one person, I know, Daniel is one, because he was a man who has come from England and got converted. Many, you see, that England had contributed, UK has contributed a lot in the communist movement in the sense, yes, those who were from well-off families, when they went there, they got converted to be communists because the discrimination which they found there, that and the communist teachers who used to teach in the universities, they saw a lot of difference between them and they got impressed and joined it. Daniel was one of them. I know when I was there in Lahore working in the state headquarters, I was in the state leadership. He had come at that time in 1938 back from England and he began working and he was becoming a big official son. And he was a very devoted man. He exemplary life he had lived. But that naturally was a mistake. Nobody doubts it. And we had accepted that mistake at that time too.
But the CPI then, in a sense, encouraged partition at one point.
Not that. I see, at that time it equated to partition. By that time they had given up that slogan. Whatever the little time, 6 months, you have supported the slogan, it gave fillip to those sentiments. And consequently of that, Sikhs also began demanding the Sikh state. Pakistan on one side, logic, if on the basis of religion, Sikhs also began demanding that state, I know. And there also we supported in the beginning. Later on we had given up that thing.
Did you personally campaign briefly in favor of a Sikh state?
You see, fortunately, I was in prison and British did not let me out. My colleagues were released, I was not released because they were considering me a very dangerous person. So I was inside prison when all these things were happening.
How much do you think partition still casts a shadow over South Asia?
Now the people realization is coming to the people. Shadow, one saying, this poison seed is there. Hindu-Muslim tussle, clashes, Muslim-Hindu clashes, sentiments. The communal sentiments have gone deep. That's true. But now realization is coming. Again, it was a tragedy. We should not have done that. That feeling is coming, growing among the common man. Though there are certain people who still want to utilize the sentiments and feelings as the communal organizations like the BJP here and Muslim Pandit Jamaat Islami in Pakistan, they are trying. But the common meaning is our feeling. They're feeling it is a big blunder and we had lived together. We were together and that feeling still and now more and more urge among the people is growing. That was not a good thing and our relations had to be improved.
So you think that South Asia can escape the legacy of partition?
Not that can one cannot escape, because you cannot undo the history now. I don't know what time it will take or whether it will happen or not happen, that is a different matter. Now it cannot be done, but the feeling is there. Feeling of more fraternity and close relations is growing among the people of Pakistan and India both.
Yes. And yet your party, your movement, has no presence in Pakistan.
Yes, it got a big setback. Earlier also, it is at that side where the movement has started growing. It is a huge feudal area where the earlier movement has not gone. There is a reason behind it, because the Congress party, who were the major party at that time, its leadership was in the hands of commercial bourgeoisie, trader come usurer. And usury was a big problem at that time. All peasants' land were going into their hands. So there is hatred against them as usurers, which was utilized by the Muslim League at that time as a weapon to instigate trouble against the Hindus and the Sikhs. That is one factor. So which laid the basis for such things there. But that time it was not there. But subsequently what was there, after the partition with the formation of Pakistan, new fury arose as if the Muslims had got an Islamic state, which could not stand the test of time, because when this question of language came in Bangladesh, the Pakistan was got to be divided. They could not keep it together, because the urge of the people being Bengalis was so strong. And in a multinational state like Pakistan, there also they could not, why the Jamaat-e-Islami could not grow there? Now it is a negative vote against, Benazir Bhutto, because of corruption and maladministration. Otherwise, the people still are not prepared to agree to the fundamentalist positions. You cannot Balochistan, their feeling still of being Baloch is very strong. Pathans, still being Pathans is very strong. Sindhis is very strong. And those who had migrated from here, from Bihar and UP, still remain as refugees there in Pakistan after 50 years. We have no refugees in India. They are still refugees. Those who are in the forefront of the struggle for Pakistan, they still are living as refugees there. Mahal Qaumi Azadi, you know that is there. So this is the position. And this could not stand the test of time, formation of state on the basis of religion. Yes.
I'm just wondering if there is, and you've talked about some of the things you saw in 47, but is there any one particular person or story or incident which is lodged in your mind that you could share?
I tell you, I've seen in my eyes how in the trains people are being killed while train is going there, how they are being, trains are being stopped and being attacked, how when they are going in groups they are being attacked and children are being killed. I've seen myself. And two instances I've given you. Persons like Dr. Saifuddin Kichlu, who was hero of Jallianwala Bagh, who symbolized the national movement. He was to be protected, taken to Delhi, and protected here. And Nehru provided the protection to him.
Your own village was a mixed village?
Mixed means Muslim population were very small in that. 200. We did not allow a single person to be killed. All were safely sent back to, they are still there. My father went to see them. Now my father is no more, to see them, all of them there. And they were very happy that we have contributed a lot in saving them that time.
How did you say
them? Protecting them in the village, whole village was rallied. That this is what is inhuman, because Till yesterday we were the friends and fraternally we are staying in the village. We created consciousness among the people, patriotism. We carry forward these traditions. What is this nonsense which is happening?
Have you read Kushwant Singh's Train to Pakistan?
What?
Have you read Kushwant Singh's novel, Train to Pakistan, in which there's a communist character, Iqbal, who was preaching communal harmony in the villages?
I have not read the book. I know he is a secular man. Kushwant Singh is a secular-minded man. He will write this thing, you see.
Are you proud of the work of communists?
I am proud, because though our voice was not so strong, we could not stop that massacre. But at the same time, people remember us. We stood at that time firm to defend the minorities. Nobody else was there in the field. Only few people in the Congress, as I am telling you, congressmen also are swayed. I know I don't want to name the leaders. Many important leaders were involved in all that. But it was the communists everywhere. And one Gail Singh Chajalwadi, who was the president of the state Kisan Sabha in Punjab, was murdered by the Akalis because of this thing. He was defending in groups, taking the groups to the various villages, defending the Muslims and all that.
So you served a purpose?
Yes, no doubt, I am proud of that.